So hi, Microbe Hunter here again, and today again a little bit of blood under the microscope, but today not only red blood cells like you see over here, but also white blood cells, specifically phagocytes. These cells are part of our immune system and they eat up bacteria. So when you've got a small wound and bacteria enter your body, then those phagocytes are the first line of defense and they will engulf and eat up those bacteria a little bit like an amoeba, and indeed they move around in an amoeboid manner. Observing them is relatively easy, provided that you're brave enough to prick your little finger. A small drop of blood is enough. Do not use too much because the blood film should be very thin. I basically placed the cover glass on it. The blood was spreading into a thin layer, and then you could see the red blood cells move under the microscope slide. You can see the red blood cells, they're kind of pretty flexible really, and they kind of bend, and essentially they are carried along by the bloodstream. They do not move on their own. However, those white blood cells that I'm going to show you, especially the phagocytes, they actively move around to engulf and to eat up pathogens. These are disease-causing microorganisms. Especially in time-lapse, I had to speed up the video quite a bit. You can see that they indeed move around like little amoeba. And it's actually quite a fascinating thought to think that there are billions of these cells in our body taking care that we do not become ill. Well, when you look at the slide under the microscope, sometimes the red blood cells do cover them up a little bit, so they can be a little bit difficult to see. And also because they move so slowly, when you just observe the slide naturally with your eyes and not with a camera, then sometimes it can be a little bit difficult to identify them because they almost look stationary. And in many of these video clips here, I had to film them for approximately 20 minutes, 30 minutes to be able to actually see their movement by making them appear much faster than in my video editing program, so around 20 times. What I would really like here is to see that they actually start to move into different directions, and they're kind of searching the area for pathogens, either bacteria. Now, essentially, those phagocytes are only one part of our immune system. They belong to the so-called cellular immunity. There's also something called humoral immunity. And in cellular immunity, it's like this, that when a bacteria have entered the body through a small cut, for example, it's not really, you don't want to start making antibodies right away. First, those phagocytes, they will take over and they will try to eat them up and remove them. And if this is not successful, then later on, the lymphocytes, a second type of white blood cell, they will then take over and they will then start to make antibodies. Again, a lot of red blood cells here, and sometimes it is difficult to see them because they essentially attach themselves either to the top surface of the cover glass or to the microscope slide, and then they go out of focus a little bit. But I promise you, towards the end of this video, I'm going to show you some really nice videos that I made of those white blood cells. Now, it is also quite interesting to see other structures inside the blood, like very tiny fibers. I think they could be blood clots, and also some other stationary cells. So we see that the blood is indeed a very complex mixture of different cells and different substances. Now, while I was observing those phagocytes moving around, I also wanted to tell you they do the same thing also, of course, in our human body. What they do is they attach themselves to the inside of a blood vessel, and when there is an injury, they will move towards the site of infection, and then they're even able to leave the blood vessel to go into the tissue to fight off the pathogens there. So quite fascinating how flexible that they can be, so that they're able to squeeze even between the cells outside of the blood vessel. And here, for example, there are two of them right next to each other, and they're moving around and scavenging the area, trying to find bacteria. Now you might wonder, how do they find them? Well, there are also several ways how this actually works. One way is that they are actually able to follow the chemicals that the bacteria release, and they are therefore able to actually follow the path of the bacteria, and they're able to find them. Those phagocytes were first discovered by a Russian scientist. his name is a little bit difficult to pronounce, Metchnikoff, in the 19th century. He was actually observing starfish, and he was able to see that sometimes those cells also gathered around in starfish, around little thorns that he introduced into the starfish. And he concluded that those, essentially those cells are able to then fight off those intruders. And it is actually Metchnikoff who is now considered to be one of the fathers of immunity, and in 1908 he received the Nobel Prize for this discovery. Well, these slides here right now, they actually show now a very thin layer of blood. So you see that the red blood cells are horizontal, and this is because I only used very little blood. And this also shows that the white blood cells, the phagocytes, are only able to move in one plane, and therefore they cannot go out of focus so quickly. I was able to follow this one in particular here, and I was able to see that it was actually also able to engulf certain probably things that appear to be like bacteria. Like over here, you can see it was actually flowing around the red blood cell to actually catch those two dot-like structures, which could have been bacteria, but they also clean up other things like cellular debris and other things as well. So they are actually those parts of the immune system that kind of clean up the body. Yeah, here again, a little bit larger. See, it flows around the red blood cell and is able to then engulf those two little dots that are over there. I think very fascinating indeed, and sometimes if you're lucky, you're able to see some of them, several of them as a matter of fact, at the same time. Again, you do have to be a little bit patient because they're difficult to see because they don't move very actively. Well, they move actively, of course, as you can see, but they move very slowly. So again, they might be difficult to see at first sight. If you want to observe them using your microscope, do use a relatively high magnification of around, let's say, 400 times total magnification. I've been using here, as a matter of fact, 1,000 times magnification, and then I even zoomed in even more in my video editing program. Well, I think that for today, I think this is again enough. I hope that this has also is also motivating you to put a little bit of your own blood under the microscope. It's quite interesting to see that so close to us, there is so much going on, as a matter of fact, inside our body, so many interesting processes of life to observe. In any case, I would like to invite you, of course, to subscribe to this channel if you do like it. Do check out, of course, the comments below. Yeah, I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always. See you around next time, and bye-bye.